So this is one of my favorite reversal indicators, the multi-oscillator overbought, oversold overlap from ninZa. I've got these three oscillators on the chart just as example to show you how this is calculating. Basically, when all three oscillators are in oversold or overbought territory, it will start to recognize that. And then when you get across back above the threshold, it'll print one of these signals, a reversal signal. And you can enable the background as well as an early detection on the chart. So now we have this background printing when all three are oversold or overbought. And you'll get this little dot on the chart, a little early warning sign. I usually leave both of these off. I'm only interested in seeing the arrows so I can use this indicator as part of my other system without over-cluttering the charts. So I don't need to have all these oscillators on my chart. I'm just gonna take these off here. I'm also gonna squish down the panel here. So now I've just got the arrows, just the reversal signals. And I'm gonna show you the price action from today, December 5th, Tuesday. I'll show you what this indicator looks on a variety of different charts and time frames. This is the 500 volume chart, and these are all gonna be NQ charts. This is this afternoon. You can see we're catching some nice moves right after these signals. Some of these are a little bit delayed, but they give you a really good idea of when the market's getting stretched. As always, I'm not just using this one particular indicator to generate definitive buy and sell signals that I will rely on. I'm using it as part of a bigger system. So you might want to incorporate a trend indicator or something else to give you some extra confirmation. Scroll back to earlier this morning. Here's right before the New York open, 9:26 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. We get a nice signal up to this next little high up here. That's 30-point move right there. 7 minutes in, we get a nice short signal, about 25 points, another 20 points right there. This signal lags a little bit, but comes back down. Later on at 10:20, we get a short signal, then we get a double long signal right before 10:30. We get a really strong move up after these two reversal signals. Here's a 2000 tick chart. This is this afternoon, 11:20, we had a nice long signal. 10 o'clock, we had a pretty decent short signal. Yesterday afternoon, had a nice move down after that short signal. Here's a 377 tick chart. You can see it's catching some pretty nice moves here in the afternoon. Here's a 1 minute chart from today, a little bit before one. You know, this is a 50-point move right there. Get kind of chopped up on this long signal. You can see how this indicator is really able to show you pretty well when the market's overstretched. Here's a 5 minute chart. We only had one signal today. It was a great signal, 11:10. Ended up going down over 100 points. Yesterday, London Open had a nice little move up after the signal. Here's a 30-second chart. Right before the New York Open, three different bullish signals. We had a nice run up, little blip down, it's 10:47, 11:20. Here's another one right before noon. Here's a 24 renko chart, catching a few nice moves today. Here's a 30 range chart, a couple of nice signals right before noon, another signal right before one. So yeah, just a ton of great signals across pretty much every chart type and time frame that you can imagine. And these settings are all customizable. I can change the threshold high and low for each oscillator. I can also add a smoothing to each oscillator. A lot of different things you can play around with. Overall, it's just a really great reversal indicator to have in your toolbox. Highly recommend it.